A few other pillars that are vital as we move forward is the concept of no matter what business you are actually in, no matter what industry you're in or type of work you're in, I promise you, you are in the relationship business. And there's a few relationships that will be vital to you being able to start this road to recovery. And the first is going to be the relationship that you have with yourself. As I've talked with executives and business owners from around the world over the last 12 weeks, I found that a lot of people have noticed the silver lining. One of the few silver linings during this time is that we've been able to hit pause. We've been able to hit reset. We've been able to take a breath and kind of evaluate. And many people have gotten back to the basics with their own self-care. They've made the time to exercise and eat well. They've made the time to read and to fill their bucket. And I really commend those of you that have done that, because that has to be the first thing that you do when in a leadership position, is fill your cup first. But I want to warn you, as we start to open doors back up and we start to get back to business as usual, don't lose that prioritization of self-care. Don't forget about your health and your well-being and your mental, physical, and emotional well-being. Don't get to the point where you just go back to the ways of old and you start burning the candle at both ends, trying to make up for lost time. You have to realize that your people, your team, your colleagues, your coworkers, your customers, and your clients, they need you to be the best version of yourself. They're counting on you to be the best version of yourself. And you owe it to them to be the best version of yourself. So for those of you that have made strides towards your own self-care, please continue to make that time as we open our doors and we hit the road to recovery. And for those of you maybe that haven't made that time to prioritize self-care over the last few weeks, tomorrow's a new day and you can always start anew tomorrow. The next relationship I want to make sure you pay attention to and is vital to creating the foundation and framework necessary to get back to where you need to be are those on your team. Those that are wearing the same jersey as you. It's vital that you're doing everything in your power to pour into them. Realize that the last 12 weeks have been just as hard on them as it's been on you. And each and every one of them has had their own set of adversities and challenges with their own family dynamic. They've had their own sets of worry and anxiety. And it's up to you to make sure that you are the rock, that you can pour into them and check in with them consistently. And you need to make sure that they know that you care about them as a human being first and as a teammate second. They need to know that you care about them in every sense of the word, and that you, by leading with optimism and poise, are gonna do everything you can to pour into them and to fill their bucket so that they can get back on track and fulfill their role to your organization to the best of their ability. And it all starts with constant check-ins. Just see how they're doing. And we have to have respect and appreciation that during a time of crisis, everyone's going to process things at a different pace and in a different way. And in order for you to be the successful leader that you're capable of, it's vital that you get a pulse on where they are. And many of us, everyone you're going to work with is going to fall somewhere on that spectrum between optimism and uncertainty. And what you need to do is figure out where on the spectrum your colleagues and your coworkers and your teammates are. And then you need to deliver messages that are where they are. And then, of course, the last group that we have to be fully focused on are our clients and our customers, the people that you serve. And once again, you have to realize that they're going to be entering this new normal with just as much anxiety and apprehension as the rest of us are. And this is an ideal time for you to show them how much you value them and their patronage and their business and how much you care about them. During the road to recovery, that's not the time to make hard pitches and hard sells. That's the time to increase human connection and show those people how much you value their loyalty, especially those that have stayed with you throughout this pandemic, and how much you appreciate, respect, and value them, again, as human beings. So as we look at these different silver linings, right now is an opportune time to increase human connection and build the type of trust and loyalty and rapport with your clients and customers and with your team, but never ever forgetting to make sure that you take care of yourself.